Where sales orders often initiate the order-to-cash process, purchase orders initiate the procure-to-pay process. And in NetSuite, every aspect of the procure-to-pay process is linked to that initial purchase order. Let's take a look at how to use and manage a NetSuite purchase order. First, let's look at how you would set up the NetSuite purchase order feature. You can enable this feature under the Basic Features section of the Transactions tab in Enable Features. To finish setting up the purchase order feature, there are several preferences you can set. Navigate to Setup, Accounting, Preferences, Accounting Preferences. Purchasing preferences are located under the General, Items and Transactions, and Order Management subtabs. While you may not need to set most of those preferences, a key preference you will want to set is the default payment account located on the Items and Transactions tab. What is the NetSuite purchase order process? Once you have enabled this feature and set up your preferences, the purchase order process in NetSuite officially begins with creating a new purchase order. Then, when your vendor fulfills your order, you will receive and bill the order in NetSuite. If you use the advanced receiving feature in NetSuite, then receiving and billing the purchase order will take place in two separate stages. Since we'll be looking more closely at advanced receiving in a future blog, for this blog, we'll operate under the assumption that you are using only the basic purchase order feature. The procure-to-pay process begins with a new purchase order in NetSuite. To create one, navigate to Transactions, Purchases, Enter Purchase Orders. Key NetSuite purchase order fields you will need to fill out include the vendor, the posting date of the transaction, the subsidiary, and the location. Under the Items subtab, you'll add all the items that you will be purchasing from this vendor. After all the relevant information has been filled out, save the record. NetSuite provides several tools to help you manage your purchase orders. Let's take a look at some of these. First, there's the purchase order status. Purchase orders will display a status banner that informs you where the PO is in the process. When advanced receiving is not turned on, the PO statuses include pending supervisor approval, rejected by supervisor, pending receipt, partially received, received, and closed. In addition to viewing each purchase order status on individual purchase orders, you'll also be able to see statuses on the list of purchase orders, which allows you to filter by status. You may find that you need to edit a NetSuite purchase order. To do that, open the purchase order, select the Edit button, and make your changes. If you've already sent this order to your vendor, you'll also want to leave a note in the Vendor Message field that this is an edited order. Under the Communication tab, select the method by which you'll be sending the updated order to your vendor, whether print, email, or fax. Then, save the record. To receive a purchase order, navigate to Transactions, Purchases, Receive Orders. On this page, select the vendor you wish to receive orders for using the vendor drop-down list. You can also search for a specific order using the Select Order Number field. Here, you'll receive and bill the necessary purchase orders. How do you close a NetSuite purchase order? You can close any purchase orders that have been approved but are unbilled. To do that, open an approved PO in View Mode and select the Closed button. You can also close a PO by closing all the individual line items. With the NetSuite purchase order feature enabled, you are able to easily manage all your purchases in NetSuite. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.